Okay, thinking abstractly, this is going to move us into object-oriented programming, but that's really not what this, or not the depth that's needed to get to at this point. Identify examples of abstraction. Abstraction is basically taking something and representing it in a simple, organized way. And quite often that means breaking a complex system down into component parts. And frankly, we could say that what we've been doing so far is abstraction, because we are taking which really isn't that complex a thing, but it is something that is not one thing, the calculation of grades and averages and so on, and breaking it down into component parts. And we have abstractly chosen how to do that. You know, 100 programmers could have come in and programmed this 100 different ways. They all would have been similar, they would have accomplished similar goals, but their thought patterns to solving the problem were abstract, in that they were not real, they're not concrete. You can't take this and touch it or feel it or throw it or catch it. It's code. It's code that's come from a brain, and so in that way it is abstract. But basically abstraction represents complex situations in an abstract way, in an abstract but organized way. So just to finish this first point on abstraction, the way that we have taken this semi-complex situation and broken it down is by breaking it down into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 if you include the main method, different blocks of code. Taking a complex system, representing it in code, and in an organized sort of way.